Hello and welcome to the weekly Wednesday Lunchtime Livestream. I'm DDL Community Manager Cordovan. Thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget to hit that follow button if you would like to be notified for when we're going live with shows just like this one, which is every Wednesday starting at noon Eastern, currently minus 4 GMT on twitch.tv/DDOstream. The archives show up on youtube.com/DungeonsAndDragons. One long word, no ampersand. Today we're on Kaneth, and we're going to run the new quests, heroic levels, Trials of the Archons. Thank you very much for joining us. We're going to talk a little bit about some of the hotfix release notes as we go along a little bit, too, while we're questing. And we also want to get your questions into chat, so if you'd like to join us, again, on twitch.tv/DDOstream and ask us a question. I can't guarantee an answer, but I can guarantee we'll sure try. So let's see, so basically this week, if you didn't know, Update 27 did come out, Trials of the Archons here. It's an adventure pack, free to VIPs, available in the DDO store for everyone else. And it involves Archons. I'll have to show you what it's like. Alright, I believe if I'm looking, we're all about level 15, right? No, 19, yeah, 15. So you want to try maybe, like, hard here? You want to do elite? Let's say hard. I'm on Kaneth, and like I say, I'm running an iconic character, because I don't actually have someone appropriately leveled for Kaneth here. But I wanted to do my regular cycle. It is on my list of things to do, by the way. I've got a level 7 druid here that's sort of the thing we got going on. Alright, I'm in the quest. Oh no, Mez. We might be able to help you out there. So, we did have just this morning, we had a hotfix for Update 27. You can find both the hotfix release notes and the larger Update 27 release notes on DDO.com. The hotfix release notes, like I say, we can maybe just talk about a few things while we're waiting for the last person to get in. We fixed an issue on the airship, where the plane's color wasn't sending people at the heroic level for this quest pack to Amrath, so you can now do that. You can also find the plane's color in the Hall of Heroes that'll take you to Amrath, and then you can go the old-fashioned way through the Tower of the Twelve as well. We fixed an issue with the Fell Blade. That's one of the new raid items. It was unbound, and now it's bound to character as it should be. We did a performance change where horned devils are now teleporting less frequently. That's for performance reasons, not just in Defiler of the Just, but also throughout the game. We did bring back Mysterious Remnants, and we made a change where you can be up to 2 levels over the level of the quest and still have a chance to get Mysterious Remnants. Now, the chance is lessened than if you're at level, but you can still now be 2 levels above the quest. So if you're running level 13 quest, you can be up to level 15 and get Mysterious Remnants. We also fixed an issue with some of these quest NPCs with the Trials of the Archons quest, and a couple of tweaks to the Archons trial here, a couple of minor gameplay things. And we fixed an optional objective in Demon Assault that was possible for someone to actually complete the objective but not get credit for it. So those are the hotfix notes in a nutshell here, and hope you guys are picking up. I know I've been seeing a lot of people running Trials of the Archons here, so I have a feeling that you guys are liking it as much as me, but let me know. Give me your thoughts in chat here, and we'll see how things go. Alright, what do you think? You guys about ready here? Sorry about that, ever. Tell you, some of these ice flints are just gonna be pretty tricky. And the Reavers as well, I found in this quest. I would actually say I've so far found them to be the biggest threat here on Heroic, at least. I guess I should probably, since we are going to deal with a lot of ice storms, I should make sure everyone's got cold resist. So... still, oh, nope, we must have a more mobs to beat. I think they're up here, is that right? Clearly demons from the courtyard. Oh, there we go. There's our guy. Our culprit's up top here. Was totally embarrassing on the update 27 preview video, and I did it again. God, can you guess I'm not very good at twitching? It's the reason the ice games elude me forever and ever. But there we go. Of course, it doesn't. Yeah, there you go. It doesn't help that I'm a cleric. Let's see, I don't see a rogue here, so we should probably just do the southern path. To myself lies the trial of agility. To the west, the mechanics path. Defeat either path, then pull the lever in the upper corridor. This will complete this trial. Yes, I may have had words with the person who made you jump right away at this area. Although I suppose if you can't do that, you're gonna struggle on other parts of this quest, so that's sort of what's going on. I hope you guys are enjoying the new quest pack. Let me know what your thoughts are, if you've been able to complete it. Have you run the raid yet? How'd it go for you? I saw on the forums here that we had one of our first Epic Elite completions just overnight, I think. I don't know, they're saying they're the world first. I don't know if that's technically accurate or not, but... But either way, it's a good thing. Nice work, guys and gals. Very cool. This room has an off-topic question about the locus of Vol. That's going to be a tricky one. I don't think I actually probably know the answer, but shoot, we'll see if we can look it up or something. We actually fixed that, Fire of the Dragon Leader. One of the issues that prompted this hotfix was an issue where... some people weren't able to talk to the quest NPCs. It was just sort of letting one person do it at a time. So we fixed that here with the hotfix. So that should no longer be a problem. Yeah, one of the, you know, we are well aware of some folks' lag complaints about the new Defiler of the Just. That was one of the motivators for doing the Horned Devil teleportation thing that we have now. We'll see how it goes, and we'll also know, you know, we did a big data center work on Monday, so there still may be some fallout related to that as well. But we're keeping an eye on all this stuff, and we'll let you know, as things progress. I think we'll know more the coming day or so how things are looking on that raid, and if we need to make some further adjustments, we will. Well, Rosetti 346. Stay tuned to the end of the live stream here, because we are going to be doing a turbine point giveaway. The new quest pack is 495 turbine points, and I'll be giving away 500 turbine point codes. So, maybe. How is Windows 10 so far? We really, you know, it just debuted today. People are downloading their computers and all that sort of thing. So I think we'll know more. Yeah, probably tomorrow, really, about what kind of impact it's having. But we have had our teams look at Windows 10, and so far so good on... and we had players, really, even all the way through beta, telling us that Windows 10 works just fine with DDO. Some people on a fresh installation run into the same issue that... at Windows 8.1 did, where you may have to re-download .NET if you run into an issue. But for most folks, it's just working, so it should be just fine. But of course, if you're running Windows 10 right now for some reason or whatever, let us know. How's it going for you? Love to get your experience. I haven't actually tried out Windows 10 myself yet. I'm signed up for that, you know, automatic upgrade thing that they were doing, but I haven't actually done the upgrade yet. I suppose when I get home today, maybe it'll be sitting there for me. But especially with Windows, you know, do I want to be an early adopter? Maybe I'd rather wait for some other folks to check it out. That's the way I roll. But in terms of DDO, it should be working. Just oh yeah, Draculetta raising a very good point that this is Gen Con week. It actually kicks off today for a lot of the if they're still doing their sort of business day, which I know that they've done in years past. This is also the day a lot of people are checking into their hotels and getting their passes and badges, that sort of thing. So if that's you, good luck at Gen Con. I wish I could be there. Gen Con is such a great time. But not this year for me, alas. Next year, hopefully, I'll be able to make it to Gen Con. I can't remember. I think there might be a... Is there a secret door around here? There is in one of these rooms. I can't remember where it is now. My spot's too bad. Let me get through this battle and not die, and then I'll get back to chat. Looks like we have a couple of questions here I should be able to answer. Last week it was mentioned that the mysterious cloaks bracers were going to come back very, very soon. Is that still the case? Yes on the cloaks, no on the bracers. The bonus this week is a champion hunter week. We're bringing back the cloaks along with the crowns. So the fiery crowns and all that sort of thing will be back. And that'll be for a week-long bonus. So basically running through next Thursday. Week from tomorrow. And then also, as part of it, we're doing a Mysterious Remnants boost, so we'll be getting double Mysterious Remnants as well. And that also is a week-long bonus, so... I'm me get back. Has the permanent shield effect for the warlocks been fixed? If I recall correctly, there's a question about whether or not it is blocking magic missiles. Is that right? I don't know. The answer is no, not in this hotfix, but I'm going to have to take a look, see what the status of that is. Someone is giving us a suggestion, saying the Shavroth blades are a bit too powerful on heroic, according to a Titan there. I've not found that myself. I've been dealing with them just fine, but I do appreciate the feedback. Are you going to be shrining BH or not? Okay. No problem. There we go. Was the chain loot reward fixed in this hotfix? No, as a matter of fact, that chain loot reward is working as intended. It is actually something. And by that, I mean that the chain reward is offering heroic level loot, regardless of whether you run it on epic or heroic. This is an issue that we see in a few other quest chains as well. When we don't have separate, say, quest arc NPCs for heroic and epic, it'll default to heroic in terms of the end rewards. The quest chain reward, though, for this new Trials of the Archon quest is not meant to give out named items or anything like that. All that stuff comes from the inside of the quest. So, it is, you know, technically working as intended in that it is doing the functionality that it has been programmed to do. We are well aware that some people would prefer not to see heroic loot in their quest arc and reward, and that's something that's going to be a longer term fix if we choose to do that route. We'll either have to basically, I don't know, there's several options that we can do. I guess I'll leave it up to the designers to decide which one they feel is best, but it is not meant to be, it is technically working as functioning correctly, it is just not necessarily the feedback that some folks would prefer. Russell C535 says, so the remnants drop two levels above difficulty, so say a 13th level on elite is level 15, so a level 17 character can still have a chance for mysterious remnants to appear? Correct. Yes. It is by quest-adjusted difficulty, so, you know, a level 13 quest, it's 13 on normal, 14 hard, 15 on elite. And then it's up to two, if you are up to two levels above that quest, you have a chance to get remnants. Like I said, though, it's a reduced chance than if you are at level, but it is still a chance. So that is something. It really is just a response to some of the feedback we've been getting from folks that they would prefer to do that, particularly on the higher end levels here. Someone saying they like the look of the quests. Thank you very much. They also say that it requires some nice tactics, which I am totally biased, but agree. Titan says, wish I had fly. Yeah, I always wish I had fly. But nah, I don't actually. The mysterious cloaks bracers coming back. Cloaks will be this weekend, bracers at a future cycle through. Yes, but Windows 10 already. We asked about the warlock permanent shield effect. Again, I don't know that one. Let's see. Mesra mentions Elvira's going to be in Boston this weekend. You're right. I think this is the Boston Comic Con weekend, and I think I saw that Elvira was one of the guests of honor there, along with like Stan Lee and a whole bunch of other people. I'm not going to that either, but it's going to be a fun time. I remember, I think it was last year, I had some event or something going on around Fenway Park that day of the Boston Comic Con, and the amount of cosplayers colliding with people wearing Red Sox gear was quite amusing. It was sort of like Gen Con on a Patriots, or not Patriots, but a Colts game day. It was pretty entertaining. Double Remnants, Civic Spoon basically asked, well, what is a Double Mysterious Remnants boost? Double Mysterious Remnants boost means you have twice the chance for Remnants to appear when you kill champions. So if you kill a champion, there's twice as much opportunity for a Remnant chest, or Remnants at all, to drop. So that's what that's about. What is next after Update 27? What is in store for Update 28? We're not really ready to say too much about that yet. You know, we're leading into, for Update 29 here, the Epic Shroud and the new Adventure Pack and the Veil. So I think you might see something a little bit related to that. But like I say, we'll tell you a little bit more about what's going to be coming in Update 27 here as we get a little bit closer to it. Carpen, she asked, does someone have a comment about DC casting in the new raid, Defiler of the Just, and whether that is a problem for you? You know, I have been reading the feedback that, particularly because of the Shavroth environmental effect, and this is something that really at-level characters back in the day for Tower of Despair also ran into, they have high saving throws, and that's working as intended. So if you're... If really what you're trying to do is insta-kill mobs on a DC caster, you are not going to have the easiest time of it in this new content. But there are still things you can do, and there's a forum thread about that. And I guess I'll leave it up to the chat to provide more information about that. Carbon G says, really? Chain loot is supposed to be level 11 items? The primary source of acquiring the new named items from the Trials of the Archon is meant to be from running the quest itself, not from the end quest chain end reward. So if you think of the quest chain end reward as less of a sort of... it's basically just, you know, an extra shot at loot. But yes, we do understand that particularly folks who run it on Epic would prefer to at least have Epic level random generated loot there. And that's something we are aware of. Mesrum says, can we have hints for the 10th year anniversary plans? No. Sorry. Yeah. I can say that you will be getting something for free. I can tell you that much. Is the raid epic only, Dr. Boombox asks? The answer to that is yes. Defiler of the Just is a level 30 raid. And you cannot flag for it by running the quests on Heroic. I tried to do that. Gemini166 has something very cool going on. He is planning a 24-hour DDO stream beginning on August 3rd around 1 o'clock Central Time if you want to see him die from a DDO overdose. Well, I don't want to see you die. But that does sound like a pretty cool time, 24-hour DDO stream. I'm going to have to get some... why don't you PM me, maybe on the forums, with some further details of that, and I'll make sure we get the word out about your stream on our social media channels, and if I can, I'll... Actually, August 3rd is... What, Tuesday? No, Monday. So, especially during the workday here, I should at least be able to check in and hang out for a little bit. Noon Central, 1 Eastern. Sounds cool. And that'll be on, I believe, Arganesson, right? Going to TR a person and then run the same guy for the entire stream. Is Update 28 the level cap of 30? We have not announced which update will have the level cap increase. But it is something we are still planning to have this year, so stay tuned. But you know, Gemini, you said it's still going to be taking place in your personal channel. He says, quote, "I am unfortunately not a part of the DDO community stream team. As far as I'm concerned, that's because that's your choice, right? I mean, if you want to be on the stream team here, we would love to have you, Gemini. I've watched your streams plenty of times, and I know you'd be a good fit for the stream team. So if that's something you'd be interested in, you know, we'd sure love to talk to you. Just, you know, send me a PM or get in touch with me on Twitter or something. We'll find a time for you to do some a show on our channel, if you'd like. But of course, you don't have to. Just saying, if you want to be on the stream team, you are pretty much a guaranteed yes. So. Fire the Dragon Leader says, "I love how fast DDO is loading on Windows 10. That's awesome. Like I said, I haven't actually run Windows 10 yet, but that would be great. It's awesome. Good news." Carmagee says, "For the record, I'm not actually looking for named items in the chain reward, just thinking that the items I saw constituted an oversight in the update." Yeah, it's, you know, for example, like with Temple of Elemental Evil, you know, that's, and Weilun, I think, is another good example of that. The reason there are separate arc givers for Heroic and Epic is to address that particular problem. You have to create a separate set of NPCs for each. And for whatever reason, that didn't get done for this one here. So that's why we have the system that we currently do. Relox says Windows 10 is faster and less resource intensive. Sounds cool. Peter823 has a suggestion saying that we should detach Epic Reincarnation from the XP cap if we bring up the amount of XP for level 30. That's something we've certainly heard from others as well. We don't yet have our plans announced as to how we're going to deal with that extra XP, but you can expect that you are going to need to re-hit the cap in order to Epic Reincarnate. That's expected behavior, not unlike what was the case back when the level cap was, what, 25 here, and went up to 28. Z332S, will KF Crafting be updated anytime soon, or at least optimized better? It is on our list of things that we want to do. I can't give you an exact time frame for when that work is going to be done, but it is absolutely something that we have are well aware that you guys would like us to do. And it's something that we've spoken about our desire to want to do when time permits, and that is still absolutely the case. So the answer to that is yes. As far as the exact update, what it's going to look like, that kind of thing. Not really ready to say much about that yet, but yes. Carpentry, that was your son that started that forum on DC casting in the raid. Need to add speed and deadly to Caneth crafting. Yeah, we've certainly heard that. We've also heard a lot of the, say, back in the Menace of the Underdark era, sort of weapon properties. People would like to see that. We've certainly heard suggestions that people would like to see increased skill ability in the, crafting up to plus 15 or perhaps even up to plus 20. That sort of thing. We're well aware of those suggestions. Really, it's clearly the Caneth crafting is a pretty big system, and doing some significant changes to it's a significant effort. But it is something that absolutely we would like to do, time permitting, when we can get to it. Some people would like to see the higher weapon critical or weapon profiles, you know, for the items as well. Yep, flexible crafting shards changed. RPG says, part of the deal that makes it a good raid is that many characters with different abilities can each have a role or task that contributes to the overall success of the effort. But he feels that basically DC casting is a bit left out in the cold there. Like I say, this is actually an argument I remember even back in the day for Tower of Despair, that kind of thing. There are some areas where, you know, DC insta-kill effects, if you're primarily spec for insta-kill, and that is what you mean by DC casting, are going to have a more difficult time. And it does not surprise me that the Defiler Legist would fall into that category. There are other things, though. I think, you know, you'll want to take a look at, and I'm not a DC caster expert, but there are things that you can look at in terms of, you know, how else could you contribute? Can you do debuffs? Can you do buffs for the party? Can you do damage over time spells? You know, damage spells? Can you have partially melee specs? You know, things like that. I mean, there's a bunch of options for you, but yeah, you know, I think the community is going to have a better answer in terms of what you can do here more than I can, because like I say, I don't really play. I don't think I'm not sure I've ever actually played a DC caster, to be honest. Not for the style. My DC caster is a swashbuckler. I cast my weapon many times and things die. DDO Trojan asks, when is the, quote, Ranger Pass? Soon. You know, again, it'll be done when it's done, and we'll have more information as we get closer to it. But I believe it is something we're at least going to try to get done with the next update. That's the current plan, anyway. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. You know, things get prioritized based on work and that pretty regularly, so it's a little early to really give you a concrete answer, but it is absolutely something that we know you guys want. You know, we've already done some feedback work on it and let you guys know that it is something we want to do, and that remains the case. So I think there's fairly decent odds it'll be in the next update. Do we plan on, quote, reviewing Kaneth challenges? I don't know that we have any plans to do any significant overhauls to Kaneth challenges in the foreseeable future. We have just other priorities. Barbarian heal should be nerfed, somebody says. You know, it's interesting, I've been playing a Barbarian a lot on Wayfinder, and the guy's now level, I think, 22, 23, something like that. I was basically self-healing myself without issue, all the way up and through until I guess about level 21. And then, you know, the amount of ticks I was getting started to not be higher than the amount of damage I was taking. So I do think this is a particularly heroic level suggestion. But yeah, you know, Barbarians are pretty darn good at self-healing through the heroic levels right now. Depending, of course, on how you spec yourself and what enhancement to pick and all that sort of thing, but yeah. No, leave barbs alone! Yeah, we don't have any plans, but nothing to announce in regards to that. I just know some foreign folks would like us to. But no, we don't have any plans, if I'm aware of, to scale back for burning self-healing. What is my favorite quest or wilderness area? That's a good question. I don't know. Favorite wilderness area might be the Sawami Gardens. For no other reason than I think it's awesome. And I like that room with the vocal clearly up. Goes through the boulder. I also like Three Barrel Cove. No, I like them all, but... No, I don't know, actually, because then we've got... got Thunderhold and stuff, so... I don't know if I can answer that. Favorite quest historically has always been Gwillenstand. I don't know what it is, it just... It works on all my... cylinders. I really like Gwillenstand. But I really like the Von Chain a lot. I'd say Von 2 might be a close second, maybe. Von 2 is a good choice. Von 3, maybe. Historically. But then I also really like things like, I really, really like Party Crashers a lot, too. I love the variety and the creativity going on in there. Those are probably one of my personal favorites. I could make a much larger list, too, I'm sure. It's like Steve Martin and the Jerk, you know? This is my favorite quest. Oh, except for this one. Yeah, this one and this one is my favorite quest. Oh, except for this one. Yeah. I sound very NPR today. Thank you very much for tuning into the weekly Wednesday Lunchtime Livestream. This Livestream is underwritten by Titan has a request. Can we get a game mechanic where we have to beat down a group of 4 to 5 bosses, then make it to a crystal to break it before the bosses respawn, like Shroud Part 2? I was just gonna say, we have that. It's called Shroud Part 2. Sure. Fire the Dragon Leader says the pit, huh? Yeah, Draculetta makes a comment about the Jerk. Like, yeah, the new phone book is here. I thought about that just the other day because I actually got a phone book in the mail from my local small town that I happen to live in. And I was like, wow, they still make phone books? It's amazing. I had no idea. Someone gonna lay on hands for me? I needed spell points anyway. Yes, I do still think the blades are fine. Just because I die does not mean they need to be nerfed. Yeah, I actually, when I'm running this, I've not been fighting over there. I just kind of draw the mobs away from the blades. See, here's what I wonder about phone books. It seems, and maybe I'm wrong, maybe this is just sort of what they call confirmation bias or whatever, but with all the proliferation of cell phones and that nowadays, how accurate can a phone book really be? Doesn't seem like there'd be too many people that would actually still use their home phones too much. But maybe I'm wrong. We're in Demon Assault. And why don't we do the optional here? I can also show you what the release note from today was about. What difficulty is this? This is Heroic Hard. Ooh, Bone Bite Hideout. That's another good. Iris Stone would be another one. Yep. It might be in too quiet. I don't know. I think this headset might be going bad. I noticed that on Friday I was not working too hot either. Epic Dreaming Dark? That'd be rad. Didio Trojan asks, if I had dev god powers for a day, what item would I create and why? I would create that's a very good question. I would say a cleric's. If I'm being serious, I would say maybe an item that significantly boosts a cleric's turn ability, gives them a bunch of jump, and attack speed. And I don't know. Something else. If I'm being not serious, I would say something that casts mass grease, that casts it individually on every member of your party. So, like, if you cast it, then all six people in the party here get greased. Yes, Goblet of Grease. There we go. I do want to. Yes, it is a good Chronicle question. I'll have to do that one. I'm always looking for Chronicle questions. Someone I heard the other podcast, one of the podcasts the other day, where they were saying that, you know, sure, it's fine to come up with a Chronicle question 1 week, but now do it 250 times, or 150 sometimes, because that's what the Chronicle is up to. But I would actually note that I've been having to come up with questions longer than that, because we restarted the numbering of the Chronicle after, I think it was Menace of the Underdark. So I've actually had to come up with a question every week for approximately, I guess it'll be 5 years come November, so if you figure about 4.5 years, 52 weeks a year, knock off a couple weeks for the Chronicle, so they just round it down to 50. So I've had to come up with something like almost 220 Chronicle questions. Start to forget what you've asked, what you haven't asked. It gets a little harder, let me tell you. So this is one of the things we hotfixed here today. The issue was that you could go through the portal before you actually spoke to the guy, and then you would defeat the Merilith and not get credit for the optional objective. So now the portal doesn't open until you speak to the guy. So. Alright, ready? Epic Home Sweet Sewer. Yes! I totally want that. you have his home, Scrag's home gets infested with Meriliths. And you've got to get some CR-46 Meriliths out of his home. Yes, the Fellblade is now a bounty character on Acquire. When it first came out on Monday here, it was an uber-powerful raid item that was unbound by accident. Which is awesome, but a little too awesome. So we had to do something about that. So yes, alas, it is bound. I will say, however, that we were not able to retroactively fix it, so if there's one sitting in the auction house or something right now, it is quite the rare bird. Yep. Let's see. Do we need to sell repair quick and then go on to quest 3, maybe? Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, Didio Trojan has the correct answer for me in terms of what I'd do with my powers for a day. And that is that I would want to add some extra kind of preferred weapons and holy folk. In particular, I'd really like to see someone who is specced for I'd have to think about that a little bit. Something other than longsword or bow. My deity really likes Kopeshes. God Ginsu, that's his name. Syrik? Yeah, maybe. What sort of flavor build or strange build would I like to see? Oh, I don't know, just look at my characters. I've got all sorts of strange flavor builds. See, I'm not, you know, especially in my play characters, I'm not really a min-maxer. I've never claimed to be. I don't want to be totally useless, but I do like, I have no problem whatsoever, say, playing a Drow Cleric. And I enjoy that sort of thing. But what sort of flavor build or strange build would I like to see? I want to see, kind of speaking of Meriliths again, I want to see a character that can grow multiple arms. And so you can have like 6 swords. That's what I want to see. Or perhaps you can play as a ghost. That'd be kind of cool, too.
A deep pool of foul water lies at the foot of the Devil's Fortress. This must be the hidden entrance that Davis spoke of.
Priests of Sirik at 5th level can summon an aerial servant. That sounds pretty cool. They will fight for the priests and act as a magical assassin. Sounds good.
You found your way inside the fortress. Now to investigate Eritrakos.
Otherwise, I guess. I don't know. I mean, I'm actually pretty happy. You know, on pen and paper, I really am a bit of a traditionalist. I tend to play a lot of traditional classes like clerics. I've always been kind of a cleric type. Or rogues. I like my rogues. I like my fighters. So I don't get super creative usually in pen and paper. I mostly focus on more personality in that rather than, say, min-maxing. Although in 3.5, you know, there's certainly a little more stat crunching going on. But like, say, with 5th here, I really kind of still stay fairly traditional on that sort of thing. So, you know, it's like I'm not really playing Tieflings, I'm not really playing Azamir, not really playing Dragonborn. Tend to be pretty basic. I'm an old school D&D guy. Not opposed to it. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just not really quite stuff I'm into. I like Warlock. I did play a Warlock in pen and paper. That was pretty rad. We got that now, so that's cool. Shapeshifter might be kind of neat. I'd be into getting a shapeshifter. Any information on when we can expect a, quote, Artificer Pass? No. Other than it's something that we'd like to get to. I know Steel Star in particular has got a lot of interest in wanting to get that sort of thing done. But I don't know that we have any specific outlines as to which update it would be in, that kind of thing. So. Wait a second, does anyone have spot? Is there something? I know there's a hidden chest in here somewhere. Can't remember where it's at now. I ran into it on my rogue the other day. Any news on the server relocation project? The big news was that on Monday here we migrated all of Turbine's billing services to the new data center. So that would be everything from, say, my account to, you know, all the card processing and that sort of thing, including all the stuff that isn't really a DDO thing, but you maybe have run across something called WBID, WBID, all that sort of thing. Got migrated over it. So the game servers are pretty close to next. I don't know if they're exactly next, but they're close to being next. So we're definitely on our way to getting it done, but I don't know that we have a specific... we're not ready to announce like a day or anything like that. You can expect when it does happen, similar to what we saw on Monday, it'll be a pretty significant downtime to migrate all the game servers to the new data center. But we'll have more information on that. We're still targeting later this summer, which is all we've really said on that so far, I believe. And that. And same, frankly, with the new DDO store stuff. That's also coming later this year. So yeah, that's why it was a big length of downtime. It wasn't just a DDO thing or a Lotro thing or Asheron's Call. It was everything, you know, that we deal with. So yeah, those server folks were IT guys and Network Operations Center folks were extremely busy. And Tuesday. Because, you know, it wasn't just the downtime. The downtime was the stuff that, you know, when we couldn't buy the service, you know, we had to bring it down. But there was still a lot of work that they could do with the servers up and that, too. So they've been putting in a lot of work this week. They deserve some nice kudos for all their effort. Any plans for server merges? No, nothing to announce about that at this time. Lord of the Rings Online is doing a lot of work related to that effort. You can find public information about that over on Lotro.com. I think, you know, they're going, and then we'll see sort of what we might be able to borrow from them. But no plans at all to announce. You know, clearly if we're going to merge servers, we will let you know. So. Someone says, I learned that Devil's Details is terrible to run on an acid spec Sork. Well, yeah, I mean, if you're only specced for the one, then maybe... I'm running this on Heroic. We are running this on Heroic Hard. Yeah, the Abishai, if you're an acid spec Sork, you're going to have some troubles, I think, with all those Abishai here. But you know, when you spec for... You're probably going to be spec for a second attempt as well, so just use that. Would be my suggestion. What is it that Patrick from DDO Cast says, one-trick ponies are going to find themselves in trouble?
A succubus speaks with an Orenahes in the corridor below. Have you heard, Catherine? Says the succubus. We're leaving. Eritrakos has ordered us to accompany him. Oh, wait. That's not quite right. I'll be leaving with
Eritrakos. Jay Renarin says in particular his opinion about Defiler of the Just is that because of the prevalence, you know, basically everything is red or orange named. That is the issue for DC spec casters. And that makes sense. I can understand you saying that.
Holding down the fort while we become gods. With that, the succubus disappears down the corridor.
Is the turbine team hiring? Yes. We do have a couple of positions listed. You could find that on turbine.com/careers. We have all of our available openings there. But yeah, I know we've got at least a couple positions open, both for the mobile teams and elsewhere. So if that's something that you'd be into, yeah. What was the answer to Psycho Magi's question? What was Psycho Magi's question? Sorry, can you just repeat it? Can't go through the chat to find it. Playtester? No, I don't think we have any playtester positions open. Although maybe. I guess you need to check. Maybe we do have some QA positions open. Janitorial? No, a janitorial is actually handled by the building. Yeah, we're in an office building. And they take care of that as part of the lease. Pretty sure. Ah, here's our secret passage. This is the one. See, people call it play testing, but it QA is, if you think QA is just about sitting around having fun playing video games every day, please disvalue that notion. Works pretty hard, those QA folks. Here's our secret door. I know that we do have one community position that is open right now. I believe that's for our mobile titles. I'm pretty sure we do have some other positions open too, so. If you have any of those skills, particularly IT, network, coding,
the devils have been researching some arcane
let us know. We might well be able to get you in here. Oh, no, I was wrong. Here's our secret door. I knew it was in here somewhere. Looks like we have big data, engineering, community manager, publishing, again, engineering platform services, senior mobile software engineering, that sort of thing, so. My job is being advertised. Oh no! No, like I said, that's for a mobile position. I'm aware of that job because it's, you would, however, have to work with me if you did get that job, so I guess, you know, there's a knock. But, we'd be attending community meetings together. But yeah.
Below stands Eritrakos.
I don't know how much the... Oh, someone says in chat the new monster manual is 595 turbine points.
What is there for us on Eberron? It is Shavarath we seek to conquer.
Because this is not just for DDO. It is, like I said, this is turbine-wide careers. So it'll... Oops. Might as well know. What did I do?
The ritual must be performed on the prime material plane. Only there can we compile the scattered codex. Only there can we launch our plan to see Shavarath. Now be gone.
Yes, chair massages. We get to pay for them, but we do. They're at a discounted rate, and it's a couple times a week. We have a professional masseuse come in. Goes to one of the office rooms, and he can go and pay a little bit of money to get like a 15-minute massage. It's kind of nice. We also have bagels on Fridays, and we get to see lots of WB movies for free, like Mad Max.
Yeah.
They'll go and rent out an entire movie theater. And we'll all go in and watch movies together, and it's a great time, and it's free. I get to usually do that about 4 times a year. It's a lot of fun. We get to pick what movies, which of the WB movies you want to see for free. It's usually like a little list where we're just like, yep, this one, and this one, and this one. It's cool. And frankly, Turbine has a really, I mean, I'm not always the good judge, because for those, some folks know I used to work in radio for many years. I don't know if you know this about radio, but not known for its great benefits. And that is the case. Well, we have really good benefits here at Warner Brothers as well. Like good health insurance, dental, all that sort of thing. Mesrum says you'd need to give up Montreal to get that job. Yes. At Turbine, but I happen to know that WB has a big development studio in Montreal, so if you want to get into game development, check out the Warner Brothers Interactive Entertainment career page, because we absolutely, I'm pretty sure they're pretty much always hiring for their studio in Montreal, because it's a biggie. They worked on, the only one I can think of off the top of my head that I know they worked on recently was the, not the new Batman game, not Arkham Knight, but the one before that. They worked in the not Rocksteady one. I know they worked on that. They worked on, like, Legend of Chima Online. They do a lot of cool stuff, so... yeah. Cranky the Eighth Dwarf says, what's going to be, Eritrikos's line in Epic Shroud, you know.
What?
What is this? Why am I here again? No. But yes, I have absolutely thought about what we should have to say. It's one of my favorite lines in the game. What is this? Why am I here? I'd say Defiler of the Justice, Shrine-tastic. Yeah, none of these positions are necessarily, I guess, what you would call starter positions. So, particularly for that community management position, I know that we're looking for someone with a track record of community management experience. And even more so if you have some good experience in community management for mobile titles. We do have an accounting department, Kaylin. We absolutely. Video games are also about finances, right? Gotta make the numbers work. So we absolutely do have a finance and budgeting and sort of accounting department that does, you know, everything from forecasting to what have you. So. You know, there's a lot of, you know, when people think of quote, video game jobs, they often think about the designers, the programmers, the you know, the QA folks, perhaps community managers, things like that. But there's a little bit of everything. I mean, you know, there are people who do accounting. There are people who do all sorts of graphics and art. You know, I mean, there's all sorts of varied positions. So just because you don't know how to quote code does not mean you can't get a job in the video game industry. It's absolutely true. Now, if you're, you know, well, I'm not gonna say that. So it says, if you're going to reassemble an artifact of considerable power anywhere on Eberron, don't pick an area where you've already been defeated twice before. Your underlings will question your leadership skills. I like the way you think. Nice work. Titan asks, do I get any time to, quote, just goof around with my admin tunes on the Mania? Typically not. Ooh, I saw a Divine Artillery in there. Nice. Woohoo, congrats, Everkeen. Even if you're not interested in the Divine Artillery itself, you should check it out for the look. It's got a nice, pretty cool, colorful look to it. And by the way, if you want to find the looks of all this new stuff, I did just yesterday put up a post on DDO.com. Where we have pictures of all the new named items and all the stats of the new named items. I just copy-pasted all the boxes, so if you want to get a good overview of everything that is available named loot-wise in Trials of the Archons, both heroic and epic, it's a good page for you. Just set it up yesterday. So if you want to, if you're also curious, you know, about, well, what does it look like for perhaps perhaps glamoring options, got you covered. So well, that's awesome. Thank you very much for joining me, everyone, and what I'm going to do is send you guys in my party here a code for 500 turbine points a little later on this afternoon as a way to say thanks for joining me on the live stream. You guys did really good. I think I only had one death, and that was totally my fault. So if you just go to DDO.com, Hyperdorian, you'll see it right in the news section. But actually, when I get a little bit of time later today, I'm going to go and copy that stuff over into the game guides section as well. I didn't get a chance to do that yesterday. Those who were watching the dev track, I was working late last night. But it's on my priority list of things to get to this afternoon. All right, and that's going to do it with the weekly Wednesday lunchtime live stream. Thank you very much for joining us. Don't forget to get that hit that follow button if you would like to be notified for when we're going live with shows just like this one. And you can find our full calendar of events on twitch.tv/DDOstream. Stick around in chat. We'll be doing a little bit of a turbine point giveaway. And this show will be archived later on today at youtube.com/DungeonsandDragons. We'd love for you to subscribe to us on YouTube as well. Hope you're enjoying Update 27. Don't forget to give us all the feedback you'd like on our social media or on the DDO forums. And we really appreciate you joining us. We will see you next week. Have fun.